You're all warmly welcome once again to Joshua Okuwe Online Maths class. In our class today, we have an interesting topic, variation. Variation is an important topic in mathematics. Sometimes some children in the secondary school, sometimes they find this topic somehow confusing. But I will assure you, it's very, very simple. And for you to agree with me, I encourage you to follow me. I should be taking the very first subheading under variation, which is direct variation in our class today. We have two questions to demonstrate how simple direct variation can be. Follow through now. I should be answering these two questions. The first one says that if A varies directly as the cube root of B, and if A is equal to 3 when B is equal to 64, find the formula connecting the variables. Hence, find B when A is equal to what? 15. So again, as usual, you write your solution first. So write a solution. I'm going to try to manage the space to answer this question. So I want to share this. Okay, good. So solution now. So if A varies, so this is what A varies directly as what the cube root of B. Cube root, this is what cube, this means A varies directly as the cube root of B. Now they say that if A is equal to 3 when B is equal to 64, so what do? When you remove the proportionality sign, that is the variation sign, change equals to, then we introduce our constant. We introduce our constant K. So now we're going to force, our business for us is to first get what the constant. Whenever you're answering question under what variation, the first thing you need to get first is the constant. They will give you all the question from the question. You have to get all the details you need to enable you calculate what the constant. So from here now, we can see if A is equal to 3 when B is equal to 64. So this information is what we need to calculate for what this constant K. So A is what? Is 3 and B is what? 64. 64K. So this equals to, what is the mean of cube root? So the cube root of this means what number will multiply itself? What number will multiply itself 3 times to give you what? 64. What number will multiply itself 3 times to give you what? 64. The number that can multiply itself 3 times to give you 64 is 4. How do we know? 4 times 4 is what? Is 16. 16 times 4. 16 times 4 is what? 4 times 6 is what? 24. You write down 4, carry 2. 4 times 1 is what? Plus 2. That is what? 6. So 4 is what? Is the cube root of what? 64. 4 is the cube root of what? Of 64. So this equals to what? 4k. So therefore, what do? I'll divide both sides by the quotient of k so that k now becomes what? 3 over what? Over 4. So this is the value for the constant k. Now the next question, the question I said I should do what? Find the formula connecting the variables. When you see this word, find the formula or find the law connecting them, it means go back to this equation. The equation you have after the word, when you introduce the equality sign, replace the value of k into that equation, and that becomes what? The formula connecting what? The variables. So therefore, A now, therefore, the formula is equals to, I'll go back to this, is equals to what? A, let me use it, the formula is what? A equals to what? The cube root of B, I have to introduce, is what? 3 over what? 4 cube root of what? Of B. Cube root of B. So this is the formula connecting these two variables, A and B. 3 over 4 cube root of what? Of B. Having got that now, we can easily calculate, find this. The question says, hence, find B when A is equal to what? 15 over 4. So we cannot find B now. So using this formula now, and I say when A is equal to what? 15 over 4. B is equals to what? Unknown. So using this formula now, I say A is equals to what? 3 over 4 cube root of B. So So this calls for 3 over 4, okay, times A is what? 15 over what? Over 4 is cube root of B. So what do I do from here? I can easily do something here to get it to, I want this B to stand on its own. So I can easily divide both sides by what? 3 over 4. I can divide this side by 3 over 4, divide this side by 3 over 4. Okay? So if I divide this both side by 3 over 4, this is it. I'm going to clean it up, but this is what I mean. Divide this side now by 3 over 4, divide this side by what? 3 over 4. That is something like, so this 3 over 4, we cancel out with this 3 over 4, leaving us with what? Leaving us with what? The cube root of B. Okay? So that is what I'm about to do now. So if I should do that, on this side now, we'll now be having what? 15 over 4 divided by what? 3 over 4 equals to what? Cube root of B. Okay, what I just clean off now is what I just write. Now, you know, by the time I divided 3 over 4 by 3 over 4, the 3 over 4 goes away, 3 over 4 divided by 3 over 4 will be left with what? With just 1. That is what? Cube root of what? Of B. And then dividing it, that division sign you saw there, when I wrote over, is the same thing as this division you are seeing here. So now in mathematics, if I want to change the division now to multiplication, what do I do? So this is the same thing as the cube root of B now equals to what? 15 over 4 times, when I change the division to times, the denominator becomes the numerator, and the numerator becomes what? The denominator. So I have 4 over what? Over 3. So 4 cancel 4, 3 here 1, 3 here is what? Is 5. So therefore, the cube root of B is equals to what? 5. Now, what will I do for B to stand on its own? I will take what? The cube of both sides. I will take the cube of both sides. That is, so this cube, go away with this word, cube root. Leaving us with what? B equals to what? 5 raised to the power of 3 means 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, which will give us what? 125. And that is the answer to today's question. Please watch this video over and over again. Listen to the explanation. I can assure you that you'll be able to do what? Answer this question at the end of the day. We have the next question here. The distance covered by a falling ball varies as the square of the time taken. Again, solution. So I want to also share the board here now, okay? So we solved that together. And I said the distance covered by a falling ball varies. So let's see, distance now. The distance varies as the square of the time taken. Varies as what? As the square. This is square of the time taken, okay? So changing this now, the distance equals to what? Let's say kt squared. So we introduce our constant. Remember I told you, once you remove this variation sign, you introduce what? You introduce the constant K. So let's continue. I said, if a ball falls through 1,800 meter in 15 seconds, so the distance is what? 1,800 in how many seconds? In 15 seconds. That means 15 square K. Okay? So now we use our calculator. So we use our calculator here. So this is what? 1,800, 15 square, using your calculator. So that is what? 225K. So what will I do here? I want K to stand on its own. I will divide both sides by what? 225. Divide both sides by what? 225. So this go with this. So our K is equals to what? Now you divide 1,800 divided by what? 225. So that will give us what? 8. So our constant is equals to what? 8. Now the question I went, I said, calculate the distance when the time taken is what? 13 seconds. So now we are going to look for what? First, let's bring out the equation connecting them. Even though this question does not require that, it's important for us to do what? Always bring it out, because it will enable us to answer the other question that follows it. So the formula now, or the equation connecting them, when I go in place of K, and I'm going to change it now, is what? Is D equals to what? 8t squared. Good. So now I cannot calculate the distance when the time taking. So d is unknown. When t, that is the time, is what? Is 13. So substituting into this equation now, so that will be what? D is equals to what? 8. In place of t, now change it to what? To 13 times what? 13 squared. So this is what? 8 times 13 squared. So that got 169. Now 169 times 8. So that gives us what? 1,352 meters. Now we've successfully answered the first part of the question. Say, calculate the distance when the time taken is what? 13 seconds. The question went further and says, and the time taken for a distance of what? 648 meters. So again, this time now, the distance is what? 648 meters. When the t now, when the time taken is unknown. So that means we are looking for the time now. Again, go back to the what? To the equation connecting them. That is what? D equals to what? 8t squared. So we know the d now. Distance is what? 648 equals to what? 8t squared. Again, you divide both sides by the coefficient of what? T squared. That is what? 8. Divide this side by what? 8. So 648 now. 648 divided by 8. That will give us what? 81 equals to what? T squared. Therefore, what will you do here? I want to get the value of t. So what will I do? I will take the square root of both sides. Since I'm having square here, I will take the square root of both sides. So taking the square root of both sides now, that will give us what? T squared. Square root equals to what? Square root of what? 81. So this square go with this, leaving us with t. The square root of 81 is what? Is 9. So that is your 9 seconds. So we have successfully answered this question. So this question we have answered now is what we see under what? Direct variation. If you look at them, you can see it's direct. It's direct. Nothing attached. It's direct. We're having just two quantities or two variables that we are comparing. So this is it. Very simple. So please, I encourage you to watch this video over and over again. If you don't understand it, watch it over and over again. Go through the solution. Study the question very well. I assure you, you will be able to solve this question on your own. And if possible, explain it to other people. If you have enjoyed what you have watched, what you have seen on the board now, we encourage you to please share this video with your friends and family. And don't forget to click the like button. Drop your comment in the comment section. And if you have not subscribed to our channel, please endeavor to click the subscription button and turn on the notification button so that whenever I upload new videos like this, you will be notified of them. Once again, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.